I understand, I mean, I understand how this all works, the law of attraction and everything, so well. But the way that I have learned it is through all the negative things that I can produce.
Well, that's all right. Well, it doesn't matter. Did you learn to ride a bicycle by getting on it and just riding off, or did you lose your balance a few times before you found your balance?
Yeah, okay.
When you think about law of 65 miles an hour, and then you think about law of gravity, which one feels bigger?
Law of gravity.
Because you can defy 65 miles an hour law, but you can't defy the law of gravity. So we'd like to say to you that law of attraction is to law of gravity, like law of gravity is to law of 65 miles an hour. It's a very big, never-changing, unyielding, absolutely consistent law, which really works to your benefit. In other words, how would you feel about gravity if sometimes you fell up and sometimes you fell down? You're riding down the road in your car or in your motorhome, and you're not sure as you go around this corner if gravity's going to hold you down or lift you up. It would be a little unsettling, wouldn't it, as you're rounding the bend. And once you get up there, you're not sure when it's going to stop lifting you up. It might let you down. What if it lifts you up, 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 and then it decides to let you down? In other words, isn't it nice that it's this consistent law that you can count off, and it never squirrels around on you? It doesn't behave differently for you than for you. So as a result, you can count on it. Now, how many of you have attended long seminars of, what is this, 5 hours today? How many of you have attended a 5-hour seminar on the effects of gravity on your body? Or did you have it figured out pretty quick? In other words, did your life experience show it to you? You just sort of paid attention when you dropped things and they fell down. Did anybody say to you, now the reason that that went there instead of there, did your family just let you figure it out as they threw the ball to you? And did you learn law of gravity? Because law of gravity just is. Well, law of attraction never ever changes. It just is. And as you begin to make the correlation between what you're thinking and what you're feeling and what you're getting, then never again will there be any mystery about what's happening to you or about what's happening to anybody that you are close to. It becomes more and more confusing to more and more of you as you are moving through your life experience, as you are letting what other people tell you about other experiences set the tone for your life experience. In other words, when somebody gets hit over the head and dragged off into the bushes and you don't know them, so you've never been aware of what their attitude was, you've never listened to their conversation, you weren't aware of what their vibrational tone was, you really didn't know their mood or their attitude. And then someone on the television says, this was the most secure, self-sufficient person that I've ever known in my life, and they got dragged off in the bushes, we would say, that is not a possible thing. It is not possible for someone who feels that way to have that experience. But because you weren't there to feel with them, you weren't there to take your own test on it, you get confused because your media tells you one thing and shows you another thing, and then you get confused about, but your media doesn't say to you, the other day, a young boy threw a ball up into the air and it just kept going. So what we're getting at here, and we want to hear what you have to say, but what we're, the basis that we're wanting to lay here is that when you accept that law of attraction is, and you accept that it is not possible for anyone to think and feel one way and get something else, then you begin to understand that by adjusting the way I feel, I can adjust what I'm getting.
Okay, the big question was, what would be letting it in on Bob and Victoria's relationship?
So it turns out, at least for now, there's no possible way to let it in and focus upon that. So we think you're wise to say, okay, I'll focus upon something else, because I don't have to let it in relative to that. I can let it in relative to all kinds of other things, and the bottom line is, am I letting it in?
So, I just get scared because it's been 9 months, and so I just get like, whoa, avoidance here, that I have to keep picking up other stuff.
Well, now, wait a minute. Let's talk about avoidance or denial. Let's talk about this, because if it is as Abraham really says that it is, that I've asked for all kinds of things, and the universe knows what every one of them is, even the changing of a relationship or a relationship mending or something coming to me that I'm wanting. And I'm focused upon things that let it in. Mm-hmm. Then am I not closer to the allowing of the universe to give me what I'm wanting about the specifics? You see, what you're talking about here, mm-hmm. and the reason that we want very much for you to focus and hear us easily is because it's a two-part process. Mm-hmm. In one part of my experience, I tell the universe what I want, and I can even be in pain while I'm doing that because contrast helps me to get clear about what I want. But then the second part is being in a place where I'm vibrationally letting it in. So, avoidance, would you say that, have you heard of the teacher called Jesus? And have you heard that he is wise in what he speaks? Some have, some agree. And when he says, turn the other cheek, do you think he was talking about avoidance? Or do you think he was talking about choosing something that lets it in?
So is it okay if you just keep going to other places or other sticks that feel better and that there's a dark cloud over here?
Yes, because eventually if you are acclimating to the other things that feel better, you open your vortex, you allow the energy to flow through, and then the dark cloud no longer has any relationship with you.
All right.
And then even within the context of something that has formerly felt like a dark cloud, you are then able to look more discriminatingly into the context of it and find aspects of it that are not so dark. Until eventually it can become something not unpleasant at all.
And I guess that's, you know, what I was hoping from you is that you would take the dark cloud away and allow me to see it right now as...
Well, the thing about that is that sort of smacks of assertion, and there isn't any of that.
Yeah.
And so the only thing that we have going for us is the same thing that you all have going for you, and that is power of influence. Mm-hmm. We do have an advantage of knowing how things turn out, and so it's easy for us to feel optimistic. But we don't usually spend too much time telling you about happy endings because that just coaches you again on conditional love. Sometimes people will say, well, Abraham, tell me that it's going to be a happy ending, and then I'll feel better. And we say, oh, you're doing the same thing all over again. You're wanting us to then give you a picture of the condition so that you can then have a more favorable response to a condition.
I don't even want all of that, like the happy ending. I want the belief that feels better. I want freaking beliefs that feel better on that topic. So that's what I'm really wanting.
Amend that sentence to say, I want freaking beliefs that feel better, and end it there. In other words, just end it there. Because
I feel like I can, those are accessible, but you know, I just dive for, okay, I have all this great success, I have to go there.
But you know what that's like? That's like going on vacation and saying, I'm going to Ireland, and I've heard that it's a beautiful place. And on the way, you read the brochure. And then when you get there, somebody says to you, avoid that part of town because the sewers have overflowed. And so you say, what? The sewers have overflowed? I've never seen overflowing sewers. And so you go and you stand right in the middle of the overflowing sewer and you say, Ireland sucks. And then you go home and you tell everyone, Ireland is not what it is cracked up to be. I didn't see one thing that was in the brochure. And let me tell you what I did see. And so we're exaggerating dramatically, but we're wanting you to know that you have ultimate, always eternal choices. And when you say, well, there's an aspect that when I look at it feels bad, so what you're actually saying is, I need to devote my life to cleaning up those sewers in Ireland. Before I can ever have a trip to Ireland that will please me, I've got to deal with that. I will devote my life to cleaning up those sewers. And once I get them cleaned up, then life will be as it should be. And we say, oh, in the meantime, you miss so much wonderful stuff that's already available to you if you weren't just hung up on thinking that you need to fix the one thing that's broken. Mm. You don't.
My sewers. Yeah, I was hung up on that my sewers needed light and love and light and all of that.
Good.
Yeah, okay.
Very good.
Thanks
yes, indeed.
Indulging.
Yes. So your new mantra is, I like it where I am on my way to somewhere better. So somebody says to you, hey, did you get that thing that you want? You say, no. And they say, it hasn't come yet. You say, no. And they say, You mean there's no physical evidence of it whatsoever? No, not any. And they say, well, what are you so happy about? And you say, I've discovered that in my joy, I'm connected to Source, and that's the reason I want that stuff anyway. So I'm just sort of circumventing the process. And if you really mean that, then you will not be able to say no very long because the manifestation must come shortly behind. You can't be happy about where you are without getting quickly to where you want to be. Oh, really good words. You cannot be happy about where you are without moving quickly to a place that you would consider to be better. You cannot be unhappy about where you are and get to anything different. What I think and what I feel and what I get is always a vibrational match. If I'm joyful where I am, then all the things that the universe already knows that I want, I am allowing, and they are speedily on the way. If I'm frustrated about where I am, then all of the things that the universe knows that I want, that are being offered to me, are being held apart from me by my vibration of choice. We think they're getting it. We make too much of all of this. These seminars should be 30 minutes at most. We've enjoyed this interaction immensely. There is great love here for you. We are thankful.